Hey guys, Becky here with Design Bundles, and I'm super excited to have you join me today because we have a really awesome designing tutorial. Today we are creating our own custom personalized family sublimation garden flags. All right, guys, so here we are in Silhouette Studio, and we are going to, what I'm setting up is a design intended for sublimation, but a lot of these principles you'll be able to use even if you're doing a garden flag with vinyl. So definitely make sure you follow through the entire video, and I only say that because we are really going to cover a lot of what I consider different techniques to achieve the look that we're going for. So I would consider this probably like an intermediate level a designing concept video. So hopefully you guys will enjoy. And of course, we do have a lot of beginner videos that focus on the different techniques that we're using, such as the offset and the modify panel and, you know, using text, those sorts of things. So definitely check those out if that's something that you feel you need a refresher on or if you're just starting out. But like I said, this should be a good intermediate level slash beginner when you start combining more than one concept at a time. So let's go ahead and get started. The first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to change my page setup panel. I'm going to change it to machine none, cutting mat none, and for media size, I will do custom because my garden flags are 12 by 16. So the reason I'm doing that will help me go ahead and set this up visually so that I know the area that I'm designing for, okay? So next, what I want to do is go ahead and start importing the different elements. Now, let me show you the design that we're going to work with today, because a lot of times when you're just starting out, it's a lot easier to, you know, be able to, I don't want to say copy. We don't want to copy anybody's design. But if I already have an example of something that I'm going for, and this just happens to be the exact one that I created, then it's just easier for you to be able to follow along. Okay, so there we go. Now, obviously, I think it's really, really cute. It's probably one of my favorite designs that I've done in a long time. And it's really good for the spring. You know, we're coming up to spring. Who doesn't need garden flags for the spring? And so here we are. So this is what I mean. You would be able to take a solid color garden flag. You can actually get light blue garden flags, or you could even sew one yourself. They're really super easy, because if I can sew a garden flag, you guys can definitely sew a garden flag, right? But you can make a garden flag, and then you can do the majority of this in vinyl. But like I said, we are designing for sublimation. So let's go ahead and just evaluate what we have here. Now, everything in here was made from either clip art or fonts. So I'm going to start bringing in all the elements that I used, and I think you guys will be able to start recognizing them. Now, this is a clip art bundle that I purchased from Design Bundles, and I really like that. I like purchasing these as bundles because it really makes everything look cohesive, in my opinion. And my mom has 5 grandchildren, so we need a total of 5 flowers. Now, one of these flowers came with a stem and leaves. These other ones did not. So I am going to move on down. We are going to use this leaf outline. And we will use, I know we use this stem and this stem. And let's see, I know there's one more. I think I modified it a little bit. Oh, it was this one. That's what it was. All right, so let's go ahead and take a look at what elements we chose here. Let's get that out of the way. And you'll see we have all these different flowers, and some of them, this is kind of a mixed set because some of them are on a transparent background, but some of them are not. So let's take a look at that. So for example, those two, I think all the flowers are, but it was the greenery that came in on a white background. So what I did for those is go ahead and use our trace feature. That's the first feature we're going to use today. So let's open up our trace window. And I like to do this before I start designing. I basically go ahead and get my elements into the format of what I need for designing with them. So what I did is I reduced the scale down and I increased the threshold a little bit until it was completely filled in. And then on this example, I can just do trace and detach. Now what that's going to do is it will separate the greenery from the white background. Now guys, that does not work flawlessly for everything, but in this instance using the clip art, it does work pretty well. So I'm gonna do the same thing with this one. Select it, then I'm gonna reduce my scale and increase my threshold, and then I will trace and detach. Now, what I can do is I can leave that colored in the color that is on the clip art, or technically I can fill this with a different color because I've created it into its own cut file. So don't forget that. And the same thing with these, I can trace these flowers. I actually am not a fan of the gold and the silver. So I'm gonna go ahead and trace these and just use them as cut files so that I can better control the color that I need for that. Because even though this comes in as a PNG on a transparent background, they're simple enough that tracing them will let me be able to fill them with whatever I need to, whether it's a solid color or a pattern. And then another thing is, let's go and take a look for this, because I used the stems, but I did not use the actual flowers. So my knife tool comes into handy here. Actually, let's go ahead and we're going to trace by color first. So I'm gonna just click on that green area and it should only choose the green. So we will trace and detach. There we go. And then what I did was those style flowers actually did not look good with those leaves. So I actually just sliced those off with my knife tool. And don't forget, we do have introductory videos for all of this if you need help with tracing or if you need help with your knife tool or anything like that, okay? Now the blue flower and the purple flower, those are just fine. And the only thing we're gonna do is we are gonna darken up the color on those a little bit. But for the most part, everything that I have selected, we are going to go ahead and use the way that it is, okay? So let's just move it off of our designing area. Oh, and I did bring over some clouds. Those are from a clip art that I got. Both the flower clip art and the cloud clip art I got from a bundle on Design Bundles. Not together, it was two separate little bundles. All right, but here we go. So we have all of our elements. Now let's focus on designing. For the background, I drew a rectangle and then I used my scale options up here and I changed here, unlock the aspect ratio and change it 12 to 16. That's going to be our background. So let's center that to page. And then what I was able to do is I just came over here and I was able to select any color that I want. I did go with the blue because it looks like a sky and it goes good with my clouds. So that definitely feel like worked in my favor. And I'm going to change the line color to transparent. So now the first thing that I worked on was the grass. And I cheated a little bit with the grass, but I think it turned out really, really good. I simply put my grass here. You'll do a lot of working with your layers. So we're gonna bring this to front and make it a size that you would anticipate grass to be. And I'm gonna hold down the control key on my keyboard and hit my directional arrow, okay? And then I shrunk those down to about there. And now I'm gonna control left again. And what I wanna do is I wanna make these more narrow because then I can come in here and fill this in to make it look more. I did put one of the thinner ones in between each of the thicker pieces of what I'm calling grass going forward. But there's no real rhyme or reason on how I selected the different heights. I don't know about you guys' yard, but grass, it's not always uniform, I guess, unless you have a very well manicured lawn. I certainly don't. So I just came in here and tried to mix it up a little bit on the different heights. Now, the other thing that I did is I'm going to select all of these now. Let's deselect the background. I just held down my shift key and clicked on the background. And we're going to move these down because you want to make sure that you don't have an abrupt ending to one of your clip art pieces that's going to hang around the bottom here, okay? And then we can group those together. So that is my grass. That's how easy that is. And then let's go and talk about this little picket fence in the background. I created that using a rectangle. And all I did was I drew a rectangle that was longer. Remember, the design is only going to save or print whatever is on my blue area because that's what I have it set up for my page setup panel. All right, so it's okay that these things hang off the bottom. But I did the same thing here. Let's double click. This is going to be your point editing. And I just made my own little picket right there. And of course, I can make it, you know, a tall or short. Let's fill it in white. And then you can change the transparency. And that just helps it to not stand out and be a stark white contrast. Okay, so I used my same shortcut, Control right arrow, and then I hit shift arrow. So control arrow, shift arrow, control arrow, shift arrow. And I'm just gonna repeat that until my fence is what I want it to be. The same thing, use a drag box, select only my fence pieces and group them together. Now let's talk about order. Remember I said we're gonna play with the order a lot. So we want to go ahead and use send backwards to make sure it's behind our grass. All right, and then what we can do is go ahead and select these and just center them all together and group. So now let's talk about other things that we're looking at in the background, because we're setting up the background first. So then we have the clouds, and I did the same thing that I did for the, here, let's send that to back. I changed the transparency. That way they're actually background clouds and not these stark white clouds. And I can arrange these anywhere I want, make them large or small. So now let's start arranging our flowers. And size is going to be important here because you want them to be seen, but you don't want any one flower to be overpowering. So I did, now Hayden is, we'll call him the first grandchild. He's not technically the oldest, but he was the first grandchild. And the reason that is because he was my brother, he is, not was, he is my brother's child. And the two older ones are from our blended family. So technically they did not enter into the grandchild equation until a little bit later on. And then Jasmine is the youngest, and I chose this little flower for her here. So we just make it smaller. So we have Hayden, who was the oldest, and then, or who was the first grandchild. Then we have Madison, was the first girl. That was an accomplishment. And then we do have the two boys, and I chose not, I don't want to say just solid colors for them. I could fill these with patterns, but do you ever assign colors to your children? I mean, like, that probably sounds a little bit weird, but growing up, we always had colors for the boys because they were the same size, even though they're a year apart, they were the same size. So they always wore the same size clothes. They wore the same size shoes. So they were always more or less, we color coded their stuff, to help, you know, differentiate for them. They knew, you know, oh, these, I don't know, this Game Boy is red, so it's mine and it's not my brother's. So that's why I chose those colors for them. All right, so get them all arranged how you want, and then let's start bringing in the greenery. Okay, and it's okay that it's on top of the flower for now because we can change that. And this one, I actually forgot when I was doing the slicing, I actually sliced this part off also. So then I can align this with the taller flower and rotate this guy. And this is just comes down to, you know, having that creative bug as far as being flexible with how you see designs and how they work. So definitely very, very useful to just be able to, you know, train your brain to take a look at something and know, you know, okay, this is what I need to do to make this do what I want it to do. I hope that makes sense. Okay. All right. So that's more or less, it looks like I did have it. I made it a little smaller so it wasn't so overpowering. Okay. All right. So let's zoom back in and just take a look at what we have, because this is where the layering will start to come in handy. Probably the first thing I want to do, guys, is I want to weld that back together. And then let's go ahead, let's select these flowers and group those together because those were already in the right order. So this flower here, we need to bring to front. And then we also, I changed the colors a little bit. You have a little bit of flexibility when you're working with PNG files, and you can go to image effects, which I believe is a designer edition function, and the second icon is colorize. So you can then come in here and you can actually select within reason, it'll change the colors for you. So I went with a darker blue. So let's group that together. And the little daisy down here is just fine. We're going to leave her white. But then I wanted this to be a more vibrant color. So I came over here and I still wanted to keep it purple. I just darkened it up to a more vibrant purple. And we're gonna bring that to front so that my greenery is behind it. Hold down the shift key and group that one together. So the last thing that I wanna do, pretty much for the most part, everything is in place except my text. I haven't added the text yet. So let's ungroup, and I'm going to bring my grass to the front. That was the only other thing. Because we grouped it together because it's technically part of the background, but when you're really looking at the design, you really want it to be in front of the stems for the flowers. Okay, so this is complete. So let's go ahead and group it together. That way, none of it gets pushed out of the way. Nothing gets moved by accident. And we will add our text. So I knew that I wanted it to say Nana's flowers, favorite flowers. And then we have Hayden. We have five grandkids: Hayden, Madison, Jasmine, Brayden, Christian. And I'm just doing that same duplicate. And I went with a purple, a darker purple, so it would stand out, and change the line color to transparent. And let's go to our fonts. Now, I chose this one here, the PN Boogie Woogie for Nana's. I thought that was a nice bold font. I really liked it a lot. So we will just position that here. Now, remember on garden flags, you are going to have a little bit of a print bleed if you're doing sublimation, because you want to, the rod of the garden flag holder will go along the top. So you don't want to go all the way up to the edge. Okay, and then for favorite flowers, you're going to be a little bit more flexible. I chose, no, it wasn't mistletoe, but it was one really close to that. But I'll be honest with you, I have a lot of them that look very, very similar. And I also think that it's kind of fun when you choose different fonts to represent the different children too. So that would be kind of cute. Let's just go with this one. This one is called Silver Fox. And I'll use that for the kids' names too. Now for the kids' names, there are a couple different things that you can do. You can see over here in my example, I just put them straight on, and that's fine if that's what you want to do. I am going to show you something a little bit more advanced today that's going to be different than my original design. I'm going to draw a circle around the flowers, and then I can double click and I can curve the name if I want to. And then we convert to path to lock that in place. And then we can move this to the next flower. I just thought it was a cool little touch. You don't have to worry about exact placement right off the bat, because we're gonna come back in here and we can move it around a little bit. I need to be able to get Christian's name on the inside. I want his to curve under the flower. Sometimes that's a struggle. I find zooming in helps. There we go. So remember, if you want it to be on the outside of the circle, you just use your little scale right there and move it down. There we go. And then I'm going to do the same with Jasmine. I want hers to curve under. Do I? Wait, maybe I don't. Maybe I don't. No, I do not. I do not. Just kidding. All right, so I'll keep that circle just in case we need it. And let's position these. And we're actually going to make, now I'm going to hold down my shift key and I'm going to click all the names, because the text is actually a little too big. But it's important, guys, when you're doing stuff like this, you want to try to keep everything as consistent as possible. I know I talked about using different fonts, and that's fine, but you don't want to start using different sizes just because it's not going to give your design that cohesive look. So then what I'll do is I'm going to select these two here, use my align to center them to each other. I'm going to right click and convert to path. That's going to lock them out of the text format. And let's center those to the page. And then I'm going to, while those are still selected, I'm basically going to select all of the text that I have and go ahead and group it together, because then I can use the offset tool. As a matter of fact, let's do the names separate. Okay, we'll do the names first and then we'll do the Nana's favorite flowers. So I'm going to show you what I'm talking about, because even though the names do stick out, they can stick out more if I were to add an offset. But I do want it to be a thin offset, so I'm going to scale the distance all the way down, and then I can just use this little arrow to slowly increase my offset. Usually somewhere about 0.025 or 0.03 is going to be good for small text like this. And then just hit apply. You will want to group your offset together, and then we are going to fill the offset with white and the line color to transparent. And so especially it's obvious for Christian and Jasmine, and here with Madison, okay? And then I also wanna do something a little bit and space these out. I'm going to ungroup my background, but I'm gonna select all of my flowers and everything like that. Hold down the shift key, deselect the background, deselect the picket fence, and then I can just move my flowers down to give myself a little bit of division. And I can do the same thing with the grass. Okay, so now let's center Nana's flowers to the page. Maybe we can move it up just a tad and apply an offset here as well. Okay, so now let's talk about what we're going to do to be able to use this design. Okay, now I have the Silhouette Studio Business Edition. What that means is that I can now save this design as a PNG or a JPEG to be able to print with my sublimation printer, or I can even just print straight from the software because I do perform all my sublimation printing from Silhouette Studio. So that part's up to me. Not everybody likes to print from Silhouette Studio, so you can definitely open this in Creative Studio to print off of your Sawgrass or anything like that. If you were going to do this as some sort of print and cut, then of course you would want to separate out some of these, like the daisy and the other two flowers, and then the rest of it you could do with regular vinyl. So that part's up to you. But to save this as a PNG or a JPEG with Business Edition, I can just go to File and Save As and save to hard drive. And then I saved this one on my desktop. But if I just click here, Save As Type, and I choose a PNG or JPEG, and then I can type in whatever name. We'll say Nana's favorite flowers. And it'll ask me, I always, and this is just me, I'm not saying it's necessary, but something, especially because I know this is gonna be a rather large image, I'll go ahead and save it in width and height, the maximum that I can, and just choose save. And then of course Silhouette Studio takes care of the rest of it, but it's only going to save the part that is within that white background or the white media size that we set up to begin with. All right. So then that's actually how I brought this one in, is you can just go to File and Open, and this is our finished design. Oh, that's the first one. So, but you get the point. You will be able to open it and use it in any type of design program, or even, you know, Microsoft Word or something like that. Anything that you can print a design from, you can now use this. You can, if you do this digitally, you know, then you can send the finished product to your customer for printing or anything like that. So just make sure that you follow along with the terms and conditions set out in the premium license if you're using clipart from Design Bundles, which I do suggest. And they really have a ton of really great clip art, and I've designed two or three different family garden flag designs for Christmas. I did one with penguins, and I did another one with, I had Christmas penguins, and then for January I did ice skating penguins because, I mean, let's face it, who doesn't love penguins, right? I do. So enough about that, but for the spring, I really like the flowers, and I like the Nana's favorite flowers because it's extremely cute, and I'm sure that my mom will absolutely love hanging this outside of her house. So like I said, we really combined a lot today. We used trace, we used text and offset, we used curving the text. Did we use the modify panel? We did. For making and releasing compound paths, and just lots of different things that you can combine all these elements, and that's when you really start coming together to be able to create your own files. And just really, really neat. It's a very robust software, and I think this is a great introductory project if you are ready to start setting up these types of files.
So guys, how do you feel about our Sublimation Garden Flag designing tutorial? I really loved it. I think this is a fairly simple tutorial, maybe on the intermediate level, because guys, we got to take so many features and tools, all the tools that we've been learning over these past couple weeks and months, and combine them and use them all in one really awesome design. And of course, once you go through the work of setting it up, you can personalize this with names, whether you sell them for a business, whether you make them for gifts. It really is a really fun project. So I'm gonna wrap it up for today, guys, but I appreciate you stopping by. Make sure you subscribe to the channel, turn on notifications, maybe share with a crafty friend. All of that helps us to support the channel so that we can keep bringing you these really awesome videos. So again, guys, I appreciate it, and we will see you again next time.